वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल इंग्लिश क्लासरूम विद पूनम टीचर वेयर नॉलेज नेवर एंड्स। इफ यू लाइक माय वीडियोस देन लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब।
अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू इंग्लिश क्लासरूम वेयर नॉलेज नेवर एंड्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इंग्लिश कुमार भारती ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 10। You can see the cover page of your textbook. And today we are going to learn first poem from our textbook. Students, today we are going to learn our first poem, Where the Mind Is Without Fear. Students, you know this one is an Indian poem. And this poem is written by the famous poet Rabindranath Tagore. So before we'll start the poem, we'll take a short introduction of our poet. Rabindranath Tagore was the author of Gitanjali and its profoundly sensitive, fresh and beautiful verse. Verse means the poem. He became the first non-European to win the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1913. Means he was the first Indian who got the Nobel Prize in literature in 1913, and it's a great honor for India. This poem is one of his vastly read and discussed poem. Vastly read means widely read. So many people all over the world, his poems are read. And discussed poem. It was originally composed in Bengali and later he himself translated it into English. We know Rabindranath Tagore, he himself was one Bengali. So first, all these poems are written in Bengali. And then he himself has translated all these poems in English. This poem is from his Nobel Prize winning anthology, Gitanjali. Gitanjali is the name of a book. And anthology means the collection of poems. And for this Gitanjali book, he got Nobel Prize in Literature. Now, which is the poem prescribed for us? It's the poem written before the India's independence. And so, we can find out Rabindranath Tagore is appealing to the God for what? Besides political freedom. He is demanding from the God what? Social, educational and economical freedom to the people of India. His dream India, his heaven of freedom, that concept we can find out from our poem. Now let's move towards the poem. Let me do first the model reading and then afterwards line by line I will explain to you. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into the fragments by narrow domestic walls, where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arm towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into dreary desert sand of dead habit, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. If we'll see, this is just 11 lines poem. And if you properly observe the poem, you will not find out comma, full stop, in middle or the stanzas in the poem. So, this 11 line poems is divided into the different fragments, different sections to get or to give its meaning. And poem is written in free verse. Free verse means the poet has not used rhyming words and any kind of rhythmic pattern in the poem. So, students, let's move towards our poem and line by line I'll explain it. See, this poem is basically on the concept of Rabindranath Tagore's dream India. He has a vision what kind of India should be there. and that vision he has presented through this poem. This one is an inspirational poem. Then again, this one is a prayer too. And even a true patriotism we can find out from this particular poem. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high. Rabindranath Tagore is dreaming such kind of nation where people can live without fear and one can live with the head is held high means one can live with the self-dignity, one can live with the self-respect, where knowledge is free. Where knowledge is free means where knowledge will be the each one's right, education will be the free. As this poem is written before India's independence, and that time education was not each one's right, and so he has a vision such kind of nation where people can live with the self-respect, people can get the education, where the world has not been broken up into the fragments means here sections or the parts. He is dreaming what the world should not divided into the parts on the basis of what narrow domestic walls. You can find out the meaning which one is given in your textbook only. Narrow domestic walls means what? The division on the basis of religion, caste, class, color in societies and in even in the whole world. Means that time the whole world was divided and our India was also divided. They were believing on the caste, creed, religion, society, and so he is dreaming that the world should be not broken into the parts on the basis of all those things. Where words come out from the depth of truth, where words come out from the depth of truth means where words should come out from their heart. They should follow the truth. They should only speak the truth. And where tireless striving, continuous efforts, hard work, stretches its arms towards perfection. Means to get the perfection, to reach towards the perfection. The people of India, they will do the continuous efforts. Where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way. Here, the clear stream of reason means logical thinking. People of India should not forget their logical thinking. Why? Why they should not forget? What will happen if they will be not able to be think logically? They will lost their way. How they will lost their way? Into the dreary desert. Dreary means the gloomy. Which one is the harmful? Sand of dead habit. Here the sand of dead habit means all the old customs, traditions, rituals which the man is following. And the poet wanted to tell, if the logical thinking will be there along with the human being, then he will not believe such kind of traditions, customs, means indirectly he wanted to tell, people should not believe on the superstitions. And if they will believe on such kind of superstitions, then definitely it will be the harmful for the mankind. Where the mind is laid forward by thee, here thee, in this word, T is the capital. And so it's appeal to whom? It's appeal to God. He is telling who is going to lead. He is praying to the God. You laid the all the people of India into ever widening thought and action. Ever widening thought means here what? One's outlook, broadening outlook means what? One should think in a proper way. They should not believe in superstitions. and their thoughts and their action, those should be true. Means we are speaking something else and we are doing something else, it should be not in that way. So lead the whole India, the whole world into what? Ever widening thought, into the broadening outlook. People should behave along with the each other with humanity, into that heaven of freedom. Into that heaven of freedom means whatever he has described in all these lines. Heaven of freedom is the Rabindranath Tagore's concept, the condition of total freedom. Now, what is this total freedom? Freedom of thought, action, words, good deeds, everything. People will live with a mutual understanding. They will give the respect to each other. And this is the prayer to whom? To my father. My father means again here the God. Let my country awake and you give the strength to my whole country. Let them awake. Let them understand what is the heaven of freedom. And such way, the where the mind is without fear, the beautiful poem is written by Rabindranath Tagore. I hope you understood the poem. And next time, we will take the next poem. Thank you very much, students.